Unfortunately, I think some people will misunderstand or even deliberately twist our findings. There's a long history of people using genetics in harmful ways to advance their own misguided agendas. As a gay man, I've experienced homophobia, and I felt both hurt and isolated by it. This study disproves the notion that there is a so-called gay gene, and disproves the notion that sexual behavior is a choice. As with most biology, there's no simple answer. We are particularly worried that people will misrepresent our findings about mental health. We found evidence of genetic overlap between same-sex sexual behavior and some mental illnesses, including depression and bipolar disorder. But one does not cause the other. In fact, there's evidence that as societies become more welcoming, mental health improves for members of the LGBTQ community. And that's really encouraging. And if you were worried that something like genetic testing or genome editing might someday be a threat to the LGBTQ community, the study's reassuring. The genetics are just too complicated, and biology and environment are both involved. In that sense, what we're reporting here is evidence that the biology and environmental factors all work together to contribute to sexual diversity. These results in no way promote or justify discrimination based on sexual identity, attraction, or behavior.